The big story of the summer was the Publicis Omnicom announced merger. What will it mean essentially for operations, local operations such as these in Romania? What will their effects
be? Yes, no, I understand that it's a very important question, obviously. The announcement only came 2 months ago. It was at the end of July. A lot was said when we made the announcement in terms of the benefits of the merger. I assume you've read the presentation that was delivered at the time, saw the webcast, and so it's very clear in your mind what we see as a fantastic benefits for mainly clients and the staff, obviously on a worldwide basis. Now, post the announcement, we're going to have to go through a period of antitrust filings, approvals, and we have to wait for this process to be completed before we can start engaging in those discussions in a number of markets. If you know the history of Publicis Group, we've gone through a number of transformations in the past. In 2003, when we did the Become 3 transaction, at the time we doubled in size, essentially. And we've done that over and over again. So our experience in terms of integration, in terms of what needs to happen, is extremely good. Same fear, people had the same fear, the same questions: what's going to happen to the brands, what's going to happen to the operation. When we did the Saatchi transaction and we did the Lyubinet and Starcom transaction 10 years ago. And if you look at what happened in the last 10 years, if anything, Lyubinet is a much stronger organization, Saatchi is a much stronger organization. So the brands have so much value that we're doing this for the benefit of our clients. I mean, this is a game of scale in media and digital, and where we've had this discussion around big data and partnerships with Google, and we just think this is the right move now. The meaning for the direct meaning for the Romanian market, besides being part of a much more powerful organization, I think we will continue investing in this market, if anything. So we're bringing Omnicom agencies to the family, and the other way around. But I think it's only going to be incremental. And so the discussion is not centered around synergies. I mean, of course, there will be some synergies, and we've announced some cost savings to the market. But that's separate from what happens within the operations of the brands. So I think it's too early to have that discussion. It will take time, and we have to finish the antitrust process before we can even engage in any discussions, obviously. But when we get there, I think it's going to be very exciting. And all of us found out this summer that this was, when this was announced. And after the initial surprise, I think it quickly turned into a lot of excitement on both sides. So we'll have to see.
So your acquisitions here that don't have anything to do with the announced merger, and they were a long time in the making. For how long have you been talking for the takeover?
I think we have been partners with Teddy and Stefan for probably 15 years in this market. We have, the history probably missed a few opportunities, now if you ask me if I wish that we had done this before, I would answer yes.
Now, why didn't you? Why now, in the fifth year of the crisis, of the economic crisis?
It's
the market crisis.
I mean, I think, we don't look at it as a... you have to understand that for us, Romania fits into a region. okay, which is Central Eastern Europe. And we are in a region that is not looking at the individual market, but the aggregate. Mm-hmm. So great talents in Romania, great creative talents, great strategic talents, important global client relationship. We manage a number of international clients here between Renault, Orange, Nestle, Sanofi. So this is an important market to our clients. So you have to disconnect with what is a conjunctural slowdown of the market. And it's not because the advertising market is declining that our revenue cannot increase, because it's simply also a function of client marketing budget shifting to new capabilities in shopper marketing and digital that is not necessarily reflected in the overall spend. I mean, the spend is a measure of the market, of the media spend, but it's not necessarily a measure of the revenues to the agency. So I think you really have to disconnect in your mind the trend in the advertising spend in this market with the rationale for doing this.
So you said you wished it had happened.
Yes, because you always say that when you do something. But I think it's also our nature that we take the time. We had many conversations over the years. I think it was. I mean, Romania has increasingly become important in the last 3 years. I think the momentum we got in this market after we closed the transaction with Teddy and Publicis 3 years ago has made us look increasingly at this market as an important piece of the regional and global puzzle for us. You know, then the momentum started and we initiated the conversation with Stefan. And those things take time. I mean, you know, it's...
Are these takeovers in Romania part? There are several of them just in 1 month announced. Are they part of a larger wave of takeovers in the region or not necessarily?
As I said, you know, if you step back, as Publicis Group, we have two pillars of our strategy. One is digital, the other one is fast-moving market. Okay. We started the digital journey in 2006 with a number of acquisitions in the US and elsewhere, with Digitas, Razorfish, Rosetta, LBI, Pixel Park more recently. And so that's one leg. The other leg is emerging markets. I think in Central Eastern Europe, given our leadership position historically, and this is the testimony of Tomasz's work, the pressure was less important to grow by acquisitions because we had very strong operations in a number of markets. But obviously, it's still very much on the agenda. So, you know, when you say why not, I would say it was in the card. It's been in the card for many years. It's just the execution that took a little bit of time, because probably the region was already in a very good place. So, you know, sometimes when you're comfortable, you tend to look at places where you're less comfortable and you have to be more aggressive. But to your question, I think we will continue on that trend. We will look at further opportunities in several markets, always with the view of not necessarily only how much it will strengthen a given market, but how much it will fit into the regional puzzle and strengthen. Because increasingly, you have global clients operating hubs. You have capabilities that you can leverage from one market to the other. I mean, digital is a good example. And the strong digital expertise that we have in Romania today, we want to use it across the region. We want to build a community, best practice, a digital platform that every agency, every client can benefit from. So this, you see, this is a lot more than Romania in our mind. This is a fantastic agency. And to be honest, those capabilities have only been existing because this is a very dynamic and changing environment for 3 to 4 years. I mean, there was no digital presence, you know, when you take it back 3 or 4 years ago, it was strictly like production of banners and stuff like that. Now it's real world-class expertise with strategic insights and a very creative input, which I think puts Romania, at the forefront of markets in the region from a talent perspective. I mean, we all know, known this for a long time, that it's great schools, great education programs in Romania, great talents, and we're expecting to shine, out of Romania, but across the region. So not only do good in this market and hopefully do a lot better in the market, I mean, that's a given, but it's what we do with it beyond that's going to be interesting.
The agencies you bought majority stakes in here in Romania recently are all publicist brands, but there are in the Leo Burnett Group, for example, there are other brands which are not strongly connected. Are there talks to take over those majority stakes in those agencies as well?
What do you mean by which I'm not sure I understand, which agency are not connected?
Are not publicist brands.
Like, you mean they are local brands?
Local brands in this group.
I mean, I think...
Do you have any plans to... do you have talks, current talks, or plan to have talks with for takeovers of other agencies, both here in Leo Burnett or in Saatchi?
No, there's no, with the exception of Saatchi, currently with this transaction, there is no agency that is sitting outside of this from our group, okay? There's none. They're all integrated, and if you look at the signage and the brands at the entrance in the building, you will see all of them. So, from that perspective, there are some local brands which are part of this organization now. I think it's important that whilst we are directly aligned and connected from a branding standpoint for our global clients, and that Leo Burnett is well connected into the Leo Burnett world, that ARC is well connected into the Leo Burnett world for the BTL part and the digital part, I think it's also important that if we have local, strong, visible, emerging brands, that they are used, because at the end of the day, local clients are extremely important to us, local and regional clients. So there's no need to, if your question is, do you intend to rationalize, and probably not. I mean, this has been successful. I mean, Stefan has run a very successful organization.
Are you having talks to take over other agencies in these groups?
There's no other agencies besides Saatchi. Besides Saatchi. No, the only agency which is part of Publicis Group that is right now in an affiliate relationship, so it's a relationship we've had for many years, is Saatchi. We will see what happens in the future. But we have great relationship.
Extended future.
We will see. We will see. We have a great relationship with the Saatchi organization. And with his leadership, I've known Radu Florescu for many years. We know each other really well, and we will see. We will see.
You both controlling stakes in media, advertising, digital, and PR agencies.
Yes.
What are the publicities? Your hopes? Which of these branches of activity do you have most hopes, best hopes about for the evolution in the near future?
I think, it's, the industry is shifting, you cannot be only an above-the-line agency in most markets. You cannot only be a digital pure-play agency focusing on what the clients are expecting, because the clients are expecting integrated an integrated approach to communication. Okay, that's the first leg. So even if you maintain somewhat separate divisions, they have to interact very closely to one another, which is why a building like that is actually quite good, because it creates naturally the interaction. we don't necessarily talk digital to a number of clients. We just talk holistic communication, and digital is part of it. It's mobile, it's digital media, it's, you know, call it any platform that you want. Same with media, which is now becoming increasingly digital. So it's not like I believe in one of the specific area more. Obviously, internet spending is increasing a lot more than traditional, you know. But TV remains very important in every market. Press is suffering, for sure, but it's adjusting itself to a new environment and will land in the right place. So I think what is important for us is that we make sure that our global management and organization, whether on the PR side, on the Lyubonet side, continue strongly supporting the local markets and talents and training and being part of that organization, which works very smoothly. And you know, it's the overall piece that I'm looking after, not necessarily the individual piece. But what is true is digital is fast growing. I mean, there's no question that we see in every market. But you know, independent digital agencies don't have the same capabilities as you do when you are an integrated creative agency with digital capabilities, because you understand branding, you understand technology, and you bring something to the mix that, you know, make the campaign work for the benefit of your client. Whereas digital agencies tend to be more narrow, you know, either on technology, on e-commerce, on the, which are all very important, but in a smaller market, I think is less relevant.